Hi students, how are you? Yesterday we read the central idea of the poem Character of a Happy Life composed by Sir Henry Wotton. Today we will explain it. The first stanza is, how happy is he born or taught that serves not another's will. The poet says that the character of a happy life should be a person who never works according to others. He is not the slave of others' orders and desires. So, this makes him very happy, either since his birth or the way he has been taught. Whose armor is his honest thought? His honesty is his protection. Whenever he is in any trouble, he is defended by his honesty. And the simple truth is, utmost skill means, truth is his, wisdom is not his. The second stanza. Whose persons not his masters are, it means, he is the master of his passions. In other words, we can say that he can never be dominated by his passions. He always dominates his passions, his feelings, his emotions. Very good line this is, dear students. Whose soul is still prepared for death? I personally feel that in this line, the message is about the students especially. Whose soul is still prepared for death means he is always ready for any kind of examination, and you all should be, or we all should be, I must say. Untied into the world with care, he is free from the worldly cares and worries. Of princely love or vulgar deeds, he doesn't care about the stories of kings, queens, or aristocratic people. Neither he thinks about the criticism of all types of people. Who hath his life from rumors freed? It's a very important thing to be happy. His life is free from all types of rumors. Whose conscience is his strong retreat? His conscience is his most important part. It is very strong. It is his willpower, you know. Whose state can neither flatter feet nor ruin make operacious feet. Neither he can be flattered nor he can be destroyed. Because flattery is a very deadly weapon which always kills even the mightiest people. Now the fourth standard. Who envies none whom chance doth raise, nor vice. He is not envious of others, especially those people who have got success in his life. He is not jealous of others. He is not envious of other success. He is not jealous of others' wealth, positions, etc., etc. Who never understood how deepest wounds are given with praise. He knows that if he is praised fakely, it is very dangerous to him. Nor rules of state but rules of good. He follows the rules which can make a state good. He never follows the rules which are applied by state, but those rules which can make the state great. Who God doth late and early pray, more of his grace than gifts to lend. He always prays to God early in the morning and late at night. It means he prays to God, he remembers his God every morning as he gets up and every night before he falls asleep. But more of his grace than gifts to lend. He never wants anything from God. But he always thanks to God for whatever God has given to him, for whatever God has done to him. It means his worship is just his thankfulness. Who entertains the harmless day with a well-chosen book or friend? This is again very important for you all the students, dear ones. Please take care of this. Who entertains the harmless day means a really happy person enjoys his days with selected books and selected friends. I personally feel that you all students should enjoy all your days during this lockdown period to attend this online classes. Okay, this man is free from servile bands. This man, which man? Such a man who possesses all these qualities which we have mentioned. This man is free from all the bands of slavery. He has no hope to rise. He has no fear to fall. Once again, I want to comment something about this line. He has hope to rise, but he has no temptation to rise. The difference between the positivity and negativity. He wants to succeed, but in positive manner. But he is never afraid of failure. It makes him more strong. So such a man is a lord of himself, though he is not possessed of wealth, money, worldly pleasures, but he is the lord of himself, though not of friends. He can be poor, but he is rich of his mental strength and spiritual strength, which makes him a really happy one. And having nothing, he hath all. In the last line, the poet wants to tell everything, that having nothing, the character of a happy life has everything. So, thank you very much, dear student. If you like this, please subscribe this channel and share this to all your friends so that we can give other students too something which will help them. Thank you very much. Have a good day.